11th grade math, I'm begging you, please explain diagram 5. Well, you don't have to beg me, I would love to explain this to you, and I will explain all the small details so you can understand. So let's get started. First, we're given this function, and we're going to write this in the form of f of x is equal to x minus k times q of x plus r. I know why this is hard because, well, what's this, right? Here's the key. Q of x stands for quotient, and r stands for remainder. So you are going to expect to do some division with polynomials. So let me just write this down right here for you guys first. We have f of x, which is x to the power minus x squared minus 12x plus 13. And we are going to write this into this form, right? X minus k, and k is given to be 3. So we have x minus 3. And then we multiply by q of x, and this is the quotient part. After that, we are going to add the remainder r. So how are we going to do it? Well, we are going to take this polynomial and divide it by x minus 3. You have two choices now. You can do polynomial long division, which is going to be long, or you can use syntactic division. Whenever you are dividing x minus or plus a number, you can do syntactic division. How do we do it? Let me show you. Come right here, and then start with like a left box like this. This is how I like to set up. And you are going to write down the coefficients of this right here first. Starting at 1, right? Because we're 1x cubed, so just put the 1 right here. And then the next coefficient is negative 1x squared, right? So negative 1. You don't have to put a comma, just leave a space right here, all right? And then next, we have the x to the first power here, and the coefficient is negative 12. So just come here and write down negative 12. And lastly, we have positive 13. Keep in mind though, we have x to the third power, x squared, x to the first, and no x in that order. Sometimes you may get like a tricky question. If the question is like this, x to the third power plus 5x minus 17, you see there's no x squared, right? In this case, when you want to set up, you do the following. We have 1 x to the third power, but 0 x squared. You have to put down 0 as a placeholder. And then continue with the 5 x to the first, and then the constant term, negative 17. Right? So pay attention to this, but we are not dealing with that here, so all good. So that's the first setup. And then, because we are dividing by x minus 3, go ahead and put down a 3 on the outside. Whatever you see right here, just do the opposite. And this only works when the coefficient is 1 right here, like 1x minus a number or 1x plus a number. Just put down the opposite right here. Or you can just think about it as putting down the k value here. All right, that's the setup, and now this is how it works. Go ahead and put down the 1 right here. And here we go. You take the 3, multiply by 1, which is 3, and then you put it here. And then these two numbers, you are going to add them up. Negative 1 plus 3, we get 2. When we do the syntactic division, we are going to add these numbers. Unlike polynomial long division, we subtract. And if you want to see a video on comparing the polynomial long division and the syntactic division, I will have that thing in the description for your convenience. And then we just have to repeat the process. 3 times 2 is 6, and then put it here, and then we add them up. Negative 12 plus 6 is negative 6. Then do it one more time. 3 times negative 6 is negative 18. And then 13 plus negative 18, we get negative 5. And this right here is the remainder. All right, so how does this work? Well, let's go back here. We have x minus 3. And from here, this is how we are going to get the q of x. First, remember that this right here is the coefficient of x to the third power. So these are the coefficients of the original, right? This right here will be the coefficient of q of x, and the power goes down by 1. So instead of x to the third power, this right here will be x to the second power. Because earlier, we divide the x to the third power by x to the first, so the power went down by 1. And this right here is just x to the first, and this right here is the constant term, meaning no x. So let's go ahead and put that down here. We have 1x squared, which is just x squared, positive 2x, right? So plus 2x, and then minus 6. This is q of x. Then we add the remainder, which is negative 5. So I'm just going to put down plus negative 5 like this. Of course, you can also write it as minus 5, right? Work that out, but I will just leave it like that. And there you have it. This right here is the function in this form. And now let's talk about why we want to use this form right here. The next part of the question says we are going to go evaluate f of 3, right? So this is how you normally will do it. If you want to find f of 3, you will have to put the 3 into all the x's here. So it looks like we have 3 to the third power minus 3 squared minus 12 times 3 and then plus 13. Yeah, it has a lot of numbers and the order of the operations sometimes might be tricky and all that. So not the best. But check this out. If you want to figure out f of 3, instead of plugging 3 into the original form, go ahead and plug in 3 into this form and you will see why. Let me set it up for you first. Put a 3 into this x, we have 3 minus 3. Maybe you see already. And then times, here we have 3 squared plus 2 times 3, and then minus 6. And after that, positive times negative, we have the minus 5. That's what we have, yeah? But what's going on over here? This right here is actually super easy, because 3 minus 3 is just 0, and 0 times this part is just 0. You don't even have to work this out. So you pretty much will just get what? Negative 5. So the answer is just negative 5. Super, super quick. Super, super quick.